Range Rover Sport. Range Rover Sport has earned the name of the ultimate sports tourer. And it's really got this through its outstanding breadth of capability, its stunning off-road abilities because it's a Land Rover, but then its ability on-road for complete driver involvement and enjoyment, or the ability to cruise a long way in comfort. For 2010, the challenge as an engineer is fantastic. How do you make this vehicle even better and increase that breadth of capability? So the headlines is an all-new interior, as Jerry explained. Subtle exterior changes to signify the changes within the car. But two all-new engines with upgraded transmissions. Significant improvement in refinement. And major chassis developments, including the usage of the adaptive dynamics. And within terrain response, we now have a new program, specially for Range Rover Sport Supercharge, called the Dynamic Program, and a suite of state-of-the-art technologies. So, focusing on the drivelines first, we have the naturally aspirated and the supercharged. Both of these engineered specially for Range Rover from day one, back at our base in the UK. And the challenge for this vehicle is to get a lot more performance but maintain the fuel economy. Customers always want more performance, but it's the engineer's challenge that we have to deliver the same fuel economy as well. And these engines have then been specially tuned for sporty characteristics within the Range Rover Sport. The normally aspirated has a power increase of 25% to 375 brake horsepower and a 19% torque increase to 370 pound-feet, propelling the vehicle from 0 to 60 in 7.2 seconds. And power is accessible across the whole rev range, as I explained earlier. For the supercharger, 510 brake horsepower and 461 pound-feet of torque, pushing the vehicle from 0 to 60 in just 5.9 seconds. And again, the torque is accessible across the whole rev range, making it fantastically pleasurable to drive. Recognising the significant increase in power, we've updated the brake system considerably with ventilated discs with aluminium calipers on the rear for the naturally aspirated and the six-piston Brembo with 15-inch discs within a 20-inch wheel significantly enhances the braking performance. So to illustrate this stunning acceleration and then stunning deceleration, we did this test at our test track in Gaydon. And there's a 2009 model year and a 2010 model year. And you can actually see, just here, the 2010 has got from naught to 100 miles per hour and back to naught before the 2009 has actually got to 85 miles per hour. Just look at the distance. And that's the ability to accelerate and then decelerate. Now, this movie's been on YouTube. And I think you've probably seen there's been a bit of scepticism as to whether it's real. This is completely real, I promise you. This was filmed at our engineering centre back in the UK in Gaydon, and it's absolutely genuine. And that's the difference between the two vehicles. It's absolutely stunning. So recognising this fantastic performance to accelerate and then decelerate, the challenge for us as engineers then to push the boundary even further for the dynamics. The suspension was retuned to match this outstanding power and performance. But we also introduced variable damping system, which we coupled with the acclaimed dynamic response that Range Rover Sport already had. The result is, it's absolutely more compelling to drive. It's fantastic, you just want to stay behind the wheel. Adaptive dynamics. I mentioned it briefly earlier. It's a system which utilizes the huge amount of processing power that we've added to the electronic architecture for the 2010 vehicle. It monitors wheel speed, steering angle, throttle response, all the inputs from the driver 500 times a second. But it also monitors accelerometers that are around the car for some of the accelerations that the driver possibly wasn't intending on, and then tunes the perfect balance of comfort and refinement in a soft mode to stiffening up to maximise body control. We've also introduced, for the sporty involvement, on the supercharge, we've introduced paddle shifts. So now, if you want to get more involved in the driving experience, you can control what gear you're in. If you don't want to, you can then just turn it off, so you get a choice. Then the terrain response system. Just for Range Rover Sport, the supercharged derivative, we generated a dynamic program. And the sense of involvement in the dynamic program is fantastic. Effectively, it lets the car slip and drift a little, not excessively. If you get too enthusiastic, it'll gather you back up. But it even makes, if you're not a very good driver, it makes you look really, really cool around a track. It's fantastic. It's really, really good. And that's within the terrain response system. And it increases the driver's sense of involvement, is the best description, I think. So the tuning that we did, and I talked about the engineering stretch that we put into these vehicles. You're probably aware that Jaguar, our sister company, has a test facility at the Nürburgring in Germany. We've linked with them now, and that's where we take Range Rover Sport for all of its test work as well as Jaguar's. We, in recent work, got the vehicle round the track in 8.49, which is fantastic, and that was on standard Land Rover tyres. Pardon? Around the Nürburgring. The big track. Yeah, the big track. And to get it in under 9 minutes is the real goal. But then this vehicle, you can drive around the Nürburgring in under 9 minutes. We can then drive up the mountain afterwards. And this is the fantastic thing working on these vehicles as an engineer, is that breadth of capability that you continually get. Other technology we've added to the car, it's got keyless entry. You just walk up to it, pull the door handle, you're straight in. You then press the button to start the car. Useful technology. You then move to the rest of the interior. And Jerry mentioned the clean interior and the low level of switch count. We've optimized all of the switches to be completely intuitive, utilizing which switch you need to then guide you through the menu system within the center cluster. We've also introduced the surround camera system, but we've also introduced connectivity for your iPod. You plug your iPod in, then you can instantly access all of the features and all of the music and everything you want from your iPod directly from the touchscreen. For the driver, within the two instrument dials, we've introduced a 5-inch TFT screen. You can use this to do all the configuration and settings of the car, as well as giving key data that feeds back within the flexibility of a TFT screen. The headlines. The interior now has finishes and materials really worthy of the Range Rover brand. Significantly more power and refinement whilst maintaining fuel economy. Stunning driver involvement and state-of-the-art technology. The ultimate sports tourer has got even better and more exhilarating to drive. Jerry.